part, it's just too much to be a whole first part. So it wound up being a part of a first part. And just to, was everybody, who was not here? Was anybody not here last? Okay, I want to make sure, because if you aren't, I'm just going to briefly just kind of go over last week, so I'm pull it together for everybody. Okay, this is stopping the bleeding. And before you can do anything else, before you can work on your anger issues, before you can work on addictions, before you can work on hurt, before you can work on anything, you have to work on self-esteem. That's the number one thing you have to work on. Without that, you'll find yourself in a jam. So, God has so much for us to experience this life. I'm reading from the outline here. I'm getting ready to go off the outline, but I'm on it right now. God has so much for us to experience in this lifetime, and He has provided so much for each one of us. It's amazing what He's done for us. He's provided a way in every situation that we find ourselves in. And so many times we get harmed by circumstances, and if not handled correctly, we can bleed or bleed to death. Now again, I remember it's a cool thing on watching the cowboy movie, and the guy's shot, and they'll go, do we need to go get him? We said, no, if we just sit here and keep him blocked, he'll bleed out. Y'all remember hearing all those cowboy movies, they're bleeding out? Or you're watching Rambo or something, and see if you're going to do something, you're going to bleed out. Well, of course, there's people that come to this church every Sunday that are bleeding and nobody knows it. And it's just a slow drip of blood, and it's taken their life away, their spiritual life. Matter of fact, it's emotional, mental, and spiritually, they're bleeding. And we need to find what God says, apply it, and stop the bleeding. As an EMT, the first thing I was taught of when I came up on a situation, the first thing I did was I established consciousness. I had to holler, hey, can you hear me? Hey, can you hear me? Hey, and they check in the state, you had to do this stuff, and you as a medic, yeah. See, you have to establish consciousness, you establish heartbeat, you establish breathing. Okay, but you got to look for breathing, then you look for bleeding. And you got to have these things going. But if you don't stop the bleeding, a person can bleed out. No matter how good you're trying to help them, if you don't stop the bleeding, they will bleed out. So here it is. I talked a little bit last week about self-esteem and self-image. Now, there is a difference in self-esteem and self-image. Self-image is the sum of all knowledge about self-image is the sum of all knowledge about yourself, and self-esteem is more of an attitude. So let's just watch this. Watch this. Self-image is the sum total of all knowledge and information you have about yourself. It includes your gender, your name, your personality, physical appearance, race, likes, dislikes, beliefs, your social history, nationality, school and family, career, accomplishments, failures, skills and talents. How many here's got their doctorate degree? If about five guys want to hear their doctorate degree right now, especially if they said, I've seen these guys at the emergency room that they've got there. Not only did I have his MD, he had a PhD. He's a bad dude. He had a PhD in pharmacology, and he had an MD in medical. He was just an awesome dude. I mean, he just had all this stuff flowing. You can see the knowledge flowing out of his head when he walked. He was just shaking it and flow out. All right. Well, again, if you get around somebody that has less training than you've had, less education than you have, then when you're around them, your self-image may be higher. But you get around somebody that you esteem higher in knowledge or higher, like if President Bush come in here right now, or Donald Trump, President Trump coming here right now, okay, we would feel a little different than if just somebody came off the street. So again, your self-esteem and self-image. That's right, and that can be high or low. Amen. Right at the same time. But yourself, your self-image, here's what it is. Self-image answers this question. Who am I? That's self-image. Who am I? It will change depending on who you're around. It will change in the circumstances. If you're a place where you don't like people going to the PCS and your department knew what they were doing, your self-image is high because you knew what you were doing, but then you wound up going to Fountain Power Buck, or you know about Buck Bucks. Just think, all right, Wayne, what's something you don't know anything about? Is there anything out there?
I don't know what it is.
I don't either. I was going to say, is there?
Oh, God.
I have been so blessed.
That is so cool, Wayne. I love it. Think of something. Make up something that you don't think.
A brain surgery.
All right, so now, you went out and then you saw somebody and you walked in and they told you, go ahead and cut that skull open and start operating. What would you feel like?
I said, what are you going to do first? Is this an autopsy?
That's right.
Yeah, you want the scalpel.
What I'm trying to say is, though, if you're at PCS, oh yeah, we got this. You know, I remember when I was working engineering at Procter & Gamble, I come by my old department and this big old three-story machine is down. And they're working on it, and they don't even know what, honestly, the people that were doing it did not really know what they were doing. They didn't know how to, Wayne, and you'll know about it, and you'll know about it, sequential timers and sequential limit switches. This thing had a lift bit. It went up and down. As it was doing this thing, it would make things happen. All things were happening, but it all was by a sequential limit switch, and the change had dropped. And so it was out of sequence, and everything was going crazy. I come by in a nice sweater, and I come by in white jeans. And my old boss man saw me, and he hollered, "Help!" And I said, "What's wrong?" He said, "This thing is down, and these guys don't know what they're doing." And I wanted to go, "Okay, I'll see you later," because I knew it was going to be messy. But instead, I walked over there, and I was scared of it? The only thing I didn't want to do was get messy, because I had all stuff that my wife would kill me if I had to come home with grease on. But again, same way. But now, if I'd have gone to a brain surgeon, and he told me to jump in and start cutting, no. You know what I'm saying? It ain't going to happen. So, who am I? And that does depend on where you're at. And then self-esteem is when you think about all the things you add up as something good, bad, worthy, or unworthy. So it answers the question, am I good enough? So, self-image says, who am I? Self-esteem is, am I good enough? And a lot of people have a lot of problems with that. And I seem to, as part of what I do as a counselor, I'm in this all the time, trying to help people get past that. So now, let's go ahead and just quickly, so we can get back into the night. When God made you, equipped you with talents and abilities that are uniquely yours. It's up to you to discover these talents and use them, but the world will encourage you to do otherwise. Remember we talked about it last week, and y'all that weren't here, here's the question. How old do you think you are how do you think a person is usually, how do you think a person is when they really stop creative thinking or they stop original thinking? How do you think they are? This is proven. Want to guess? 5. What am I talking about by creative? I'm talking about as soon as a kid goes to school, he starts hearing, you can't do it this way, you got to do it this way. His peer pressure, all this stuff, you're still a critic, you're still an original thinker. No, I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about in the workplace, in the thing. And then you spend the next few years being kind of put down, then you got to come back up. Okay? And the average man dies. This is this. The average man dies at 25. He just isn't buried until 70, 75 years old. About 25 years old, you just kind of go with the flow. Now, people like Wayne, or people like y'all guys, me, we don't go with the flow. And so, you know, I didn't die at 25. But I've got people I know that they're just going with the flow. They're just, you know, and a dead fish can swim downstream. Did you know that? A dead fish can swim downstream. So anybody can follow the stream, but it takes the mighty salmon to go up against the stream. Okay? And we got a lot of salmon in here. All right, so here we go. Maintain a healthy self-image is a matter of doing 3 things. Number 1, obeying God, which produces a clear conscience. We talked about that. Thinking healthy thoughts, which produces a healthy conscience, one's clear, one's healthy, and finding a purpose for life that pleases your Creator produces a powerful conscience. So that's where we stopped last week. So the following common sense, biblically based tips can help you build the kind of self-image and the kind of life that you and God can be proud of. So number 1, Watch this. This is so simple. Learn to do the right thing. Wow. That's pretty simple, isn't it? Some of this stuff's so simple like falling off a log, but then you think about it. It's so simple that sometimes it escapes us. Do the right thing. Even if nobody else is doing the right thing, it's okay to do the right thing. If everybody else, you know, my mom would say, if they jumped off the cliff, would you jump off the cliff? No, Mama. Yeah, you would. Okay, Mama. Do the right thing. If you're misbehaving, how can you possibly hope to feel good about yourself? That's pretty awesome. It's pretty strong. It's strong, but it's awesome. But it is, okay? So Romans 14:12, so then each of us shall give an account of himself to God. If you're misbehaving, if you're involved in stuff that, watch this. If you're fighting to keep doing stuff that Jesus died for, then you got a problem. And it'll tear your conscience. Alright, number two. Watch what you think. Your inner voice is, in reality, your inner critic. You need to tone down the criticism now. Train yourself to begin thinking thoughts that are more rational, more accepting, and less judgmental. Philippians 4:8, find out, brothers, what sort of things are true, what are noble, what are just, what are pure, what are lovely, what are good report. If there be any virtue in these things, praiseworthy, meditate on these things.